So in this video, I'm going to talk about how to create web files on your iPad if you're using an iPad for this class. So right now I'm in the Apple Store, and I just, as you can see, I typed in code editor, and there's a few things that come up. I really want you to be able to use something that's free. So the one that I'm gonna recommend is the Coder with a K, code editor, and it's free. As you can see, I've already downloaded it. So mine says open, but yours would say get. You just click on that and go ahead and let it download. And now I'm gonna go ahead and open it. So this is what the interface looks like. It's very easy to use. Now, if you're first using it, you wouldn't have anything on that left-hand side where it has a home button, local select. But basically the tab here that's got the little, iPhone looking icon, that is your local system. So that's the file saved on the iPad. And then the second tab that I'm just switching to now, this one is your FTP. So this is where, when you hit module 4, you would set up your FTP connection so that you could actually transfer your files to the web. For right now, we don't need that. I'll do a separate video for module 4. But I want to show you here how you can set up a structure and create files. So if you go ahead and hit that plus sign down at the bottom, you see that it gives you some different options here. So for example, if you wanted to, you could import images into your project using the Photos import. You can import files if you had files already created, but I'm gonna assume if this is what you're using, you would need new files. So notice you can create a folder structure. There's that new folder there, and I've created a couple examples there. And we're in this, in the 380, we're just working on single files. So that's not such a big deal, but in the 381, we talk about folder structure. So eventually that's gonna be important. So for now though, let's just go ahead and say new file. And you would do just like I talked about, if you were using Notepad or if you were using Edity, you want to name the file and you do want to use the HTML extension. So I already have one called test. So I'm going to call this one test2.html. And I'm going to go ahead and create it. And it's just going to put it on whatever, wherever I am in the folder structure. So if I had been here and I did new, it would create it in that folder called images. And then you just hit home to get yourself back out to the main file. Okay, so test 2 is totally blank. There's nothing in it, but you would just go ahead and click on the right hand side there and it starts to give you the line, and you would just go ahead and code just following all the same instructions that I've given in all the other videos. This works exactly the same way, where you're just going to use the tags that you need and create the structure in exactly the same way. So the coding, the syntax, all those other lessons apply. Nothing else is different. It's just, this is just a different interface for creating these files. So I'm just going to create a quick structure here. So that would be your just typical HTML. And I do just want to illustrate here how to preview a page. So I'm going to toss a little bit of content on here. So you don't need to explicitly sort of save. Oh yeah, notice it does have some contextual help for you sometimes. It doesn't, I mean, like this isn't super helpful in this moment, but you'll find at some points it is helpful, and I'll show you that in a second. But you don't have to explicitly save. You just click back over on the left to basically save the file. And if you notice, when I'm in this code view, we get this new little menu bar at the top. If you hit the one that looks like an eyeball, it will allow you to preview your page in a browser. So you can actually see what it, you know, how it renders. The code state that just allows you to view the source, and then the X to get us back to where we were in the edit view. Okay, so that's easy enough. I wanted to show you that it does indeed work to add your CSS in the header. Just as like I talked about in the videos, when you get to there, if you haven't gotten there yet. So let's just make a couple of simple changes. And go ahead back here and preview. And you can see now we've got a green background and the font has changed. So you can do all the same things that videos explain in the class. You're just using a different interface in order to do it. So I just wanted to reinforce that and give you a little tour of how this interface works.